Hi everyone, I hope you're all doing well. I hope you are managing with the quarantine. I know, just speaking from my point of view, it's been very difficult. I'm very glad to be here in Buenos Aires, but it's been a challenging experience to the extent that I haven't been able to meet people, or to, what I mean is to go out and to meet people. I think the pandemic has really affected people's mental health, and of course, it's has struck a terrible toll on the human race. I mean, as I speak, 700,000 people have died of COVID-19, and I think we are now approaching 20 million infections. It's a terrible pandemic. So I just hope that you're all doing well and that you are somehow managing through this dark time in human history. Of course, we will come out of it, but we need to be patient. And on the other hand, I think this is a great chance for you to improve your English skills. So I really recommend that you listen to the radio, that you try to read English more. If you have the opportunity to watch YouTube videos in English, even to buy a textbook, or just take the time now to improve your English. So in the meantime, I've been tutoring and also reading. As you know, I love reading philosophy. That's my favorite subject, and I've been reading quite some interesting stuff. Like an example of some philosophy that I've been reading is Mary's Room. It's a thought experiment in philosophy, and it goes like this. Imagine that there is an exceptional neuroscientist called Mary. And Mary knows all of the physical properties of colors. So she knows their wavelengths, she knows their every single property. Every single property. Every si physical property. Because unfortunately, Mary is blind. So while she knows every single physical property of color, the question is, does she really know color? Are there non-physical properties of colors? To the extent that you need to experience color phenomenally in terms of your own experience and the appearance of color to truly understand what colors are. Now, I think we can extend this thought experiment to even to learning English, really, if you think about it. So, when we're learning English, we learn the rules, we learn the vocabulary, we learn the building blocks of English. But as you know, there is good English and there is bad English. And that's really an experience of the language. It's not something physical. It doesn't take physical form. Like, it's not some ink on a piece of paper. It's not some, it's not even some physical object. But it's just good English. You can know all the rules about English, all of the nuances, everything about English. But do you really know English? I would say no, you don't. You need to actually speak the language. You need to practice the language. There's some kind of experience attached to speaking English that you cannot formulate as you learn the rules of the language, as you will learn the forms, the constructions. Such a way is insufficient. The Mary Room thought experiment tries to show that you can know all the physical properties of something. You can, if we extend it to English, all the rules, constructions, idioms, etc. But since you haven't felt English, in the same way you haven't felt a color, you don't really know English. Okay? And my role is to give you this experience of English. So while you know all the properties of English, the grammar, the rules, the idioms, you have that non-physical stuff of English that can make you sound like a native speaker, that can so that you speak naturally, you speak good English. So I wish you a very good Sunday, and I look forward to our next lessons together. Thank you very much. Thank you. Goodbye.